Do you ever feel like you just can't relax? Like, however much work you've done and however successful you've been, there's always something nagging at you and you can't properly switch off. This can be true whether you work for yourself and you own a business and you've got a whole load of people and employees and people who you need to support and who you want to support. And it can also be true if you're a professional and you've got all these responsibilities, the organization that you work for and the people that depend on you need you to do stuff. It can feel really, really hard to ever switch off. And people often talk about work-life balance as a way of managing this. I don't think that's really a very good metaphor at all. The problem with the idea of work-life balance is it's a zero-sum game. You have work and you have your outside of work life, and they have to be some way negotiated when one wins, the other one loses, and you've got to reach this balance point between them. It's always coming from a place of scarcity, and no wonder you feel depleted and under tension when there is always this tension between your rest and your bodily needs and the work that you're trying to do. So the phrase zero-sum game, which is what this is, it comes from game theory, which is a series of mathematical ideas that model different ways that we can behave and different ways that we can think about the world. In a zero-sum game, when someone or something wins, someone or something loses in an equal and opposite amount. There's no net change at all. However, there are other sorts of games. There's a different kind of game called a positive-sum game. In that game, basically everyone wins by playing. This is the kind of game that I'd like you to think of your life and your work as being. To do this, look for ways that your work life can support your home life. Instead of seeing these things as tension, think about how they relate. What at home makes you better at work? What at work makes you better at home? After all, it's all just life. There is no work you and there is no home you. Your happiness is a complete picture, not just this individual thing that you can separate up into two little boxes or two little kind of ends of a balance that have to be constantly in tension with each other. You can think of your life and the work that you're trying to do as creating a garden. Your garden gives you flowers and they're beautiful and gives you enjoyment. It also nourishes you, it gives you food, and it gives you what you need to live and what you need to support the people that you love. So if we take your work and your life as, think of it as a watering can. You want the role of the watering can and the good that the watering can does is by pouring water on the plants that you want to grow. The thing is, without filling it up, without resourcing the work, then you can't actually do any good. If you just tip an empty watering can, nothing comes out, right? It doesn't water the flowers. And the other thing is, over time, that watering can, maybe you drop it, maybe it gets bashed, maybe it gets clogged up, and it doesn't work so well. And it needs you to spend some time mending it and repairing it so that it works more effectively. And if you think of your work and your whole life as this relationship between doing the actual thing, creating the value, supporting yourself and building up the value in you, and then resting and repairing afterwards, then they all support each other. There's no tension between these two things, between these three things, sorry. Everything that you do supports the other thing. This is a much different way of seeing work and thinking about your work in terms of that creation, that active creation of value and creation of what you really want to do. The stuff you do around that, so that might be reading, training, all of the things that build up the inspiration that make you more capable of doing that. And finally, the rest and the repair and the reflection. How do those things relate for you? So have a think about that. Have a think about which things fall into each of those three categories for you and how you can make them link up with each other a bit better. And instead of seeing them as fighting with each other in intention, how can you make them both win at the same time? How can you make all these things grow together? Do let me know what those things are for you in the comments and how you get on.